Hi everybody, welcome to today's lesson. Today we're going to be playing a song called You and I by Wilco. And it's a pretty simple song, but there's a lot you can do with it to spice things up. So I'll cover a few different variations in this lesson, and then at the end I'll put it all together and show you what it sounds like to the track. So first thing is the main riff. So if you want to call it a riff, it's more of just a chord pattern, but we're alternating between two different chords. The first is just your regular C. And then the second is an A minor, but with this different middle note. So normal A minor is like this. On this A minor, you take that middle finger, you move it instead to the fourth string where your ring finger would usually be, and then you don't use your ring finger when playing this one. Instead, you use your pinky finger and you place that on the third string, fourth fret, and it sounds like this. So it gives you kind of that, like, almost augmented sort of sound. And for the main riff, you just alternate between those. So it goes. Okay, so we'll take a look at the strumming pattern as well. So it's just down, 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 and right here, there's two ups. So that's really the only place where it's gonna vary from the down up is right in the middle where I just showed, where you have two upstrokes basically in a row. So one more time. Up, up, right there. So you do that back and forth. And that's, you know, where he's singing you and I, you and I. And I'll link to some chord tabs for this song on Ultimate Guitar, because that will have all the chords that you need. But the next section, he goes, and this is still in the verse, but it's just after the C and the altered A minor, he plays C. He does a C over B. So this F, C, C over B walk down is sort of very common in a lot of songs, because it just really has a pleasant sound, just walking down that chord, and it's easy to play too. So the C over B is, you just take your middle finger off that fourth string and you put it onto the fifth string on the second fret, and you're really only fretting two strings at that point. And then the F, I mean, you can play it as a bar chord, but I find, especially with the walk down, it's easier to fret the sixth string, the bass string, with your thumb, because that really lets you go easily into the C shape. You're just moving one finger, basically. The bridge, which is just C and F. You And then on that F, at the very end, you can lift the middle finger, and that will play an F major 7. And now he goes back to the verse, and it's basically the same chords. Actually, it is basically the exact same progression, so I won't play it again. And then up comes the chorus section. So, well, actually, I feel like it's more like a bridge. I think they're mislabeled in the tab. But he goes. Back to that E minor. The C, A minor 9. And here's really the only variation from what I described before. It's more of a chordal walk down. So it's a C, then a B flat, then an A minor. G6, which is just a G with no note here on the first string, and then he goes into the G7, which keeps the sound really open-ended to go back into that verse. So G7, you just play on the first fret here on the first string. So I'll play that all at once. It's the same strumming pattern the whole way through. And then he just goes back into his U and I thing. And yeah, the outro is just back to that C and F. And he does that about 8 times. So there you have it, pretty simple song. And now I'm just going to go and play through the whole thing with the recording.